Before we leave, let me tell y'all a little something. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. I said uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. I said uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up.
We're all busy with plenty of commitments. That's why Anytime Fitness is the perfect way to stay in shape. From either home or work, Anytime Fitness of Thurmont is always close by, and they're open 24/7. They can tailor a personalized training program to fit your workout needs. Anytime Fitness can also fashion a membership and payment plan that will be flexible enough for your on-the-go lifestyle. You'll love the 24-hour co-ed fitness center with state-of-the-art equipment designed to sculpt and tune you into shape. And when you're away from the Thurmont area, your membership guarantees you access to any of the over 1,000 clubs worldwide. Visit us at 130 Frederick Road to start your program today. Now you can stay healthy anytime. It's a 130 Frederick Road to start your program today. Now you can stay healthy anytime with Anytime Fitness.
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Catoctin High School, home of the Cougars, and we're into playoff football here tonight. That's right, it's Friday Night Lights, week one of the high school football playoff season. And Catoctin at 9-1 hosts Boonesboro tonight. These two teams met way back on August the 31st. Great deal of respect between Coach Williams and Coach Anders. Both coaches are veterans in high school football, and their teams meet early every season, trading fields each year. So this game has been will be very evenly balanced. Field conditions will be a big factor, and we're excited to bring you the 1A West Regional Semifinal. My name is Michael Betteridge. I'll be doing your play-by-play. Joined here, color analyst Will Burns, videographer Hollis Zimmerman. How's it look out there, Will?
It is messy out there tonight. I live up near Cascade. It has been raining all day. The field is probably completely saturated. It's going to be hard to get any kind of footing tonight.
Will, you had a little research you did on playoff football here at Catoctin. Tell us a little bit about it.
This will be the first Catoctin home game, actually, playoff home game, since we've hosted.
Okay, we're going to step aside for the anthem.
MedOne Pharmacy is the largest locally owned and operated pharmacy in Frederick County. MedOne Pharmacy has four locations in Brunswick, Emmitsburg, Middletown, and Thurmont to provide you with convenience, experience, service, tradition, and value. MedOne Pharmacy. Check out their website at MedOnePharmacy.com. That's M-E-D-O-N-E Pharmacy.com today. Or for more information, call them at 301-271-2223.
MedOne Pharmacy is a proud sponsor of Frederick County Public School Athletics.
Serving our community for over 50 years with quality service at a fair price, Brownies Auto Repair employs only ASE certified technicians. Brownies is one of only 33 shops in the state of Maryland designated as an ASE Blue Seal of Excellence repair facility. They want to help you maintain your vehicle in a manner that keeps it trouble-free and fun to drive. Stop by today. That's Brownies Auto Repair, located on Frederick Street in Walkersville, a proud sponsor of Walkersville High School Athletics.
I loved playing high school sports. I loved the competition, the camaraderie, the bands, the crowds, all the pageantry, and I wanted to keep playing. But I graduated. No colleges called, and neither did the pros. So, to stay close to the game I loved, I decided to become a high school official. You know, a referee. When I played high school sports, I learned the importance of integrity, good sportsmanship, and respect for the rules. Now, as a high school official, I get to help model these same values to others. Maybe the colleges and the pros didn't call, but the kids in Maryland did. And now, I'm enjoying the competition, the camaraderie, the bands, the crowds, and all the pageantry of high school sports all over again.
This message presented by the Maryland Public Secondary Schools Athletic Association and the Maryland State Athletic Directors Association.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Catoctin High School. I want to thank our sponsors for making this game possible. Brownies Auto Care, Catoctin Wildlife Preserve, Cousins Ace Hardware of Thurmont, David's Salon, and DentedToolbox.com. along with Gettysburg Auto Auction, Happy Dog Groomers, Shuff's Meat Market, and our newest sponsor to join the party, Woodsboro Bank. We're ready for our opening kickoff here. The Boonesboro Warriors will be kicking off left to right on your radio dial to the Catoctin Cougars on a very wet field. It has stopped raining, just a light sprinkle drizzle coming down on a perfect night for high school football. There's a short end-over-end kick taken at the 20. He drops it, picks it up on the one hopper, and now he runs it straight ahead and gets immediately tackled and dropped at the 14-yard line, forward progress mark. So right away, Will, we see a wet football and a lot of bouncing around going on out there.
Yep, definitely. Exactly what we expected tonight. First play, it happens.
I want to remind everybody, if you had logged in earlier and connected to our Watch Live video stream, we had a problem with the first feed. We killed it. We pulled up a second feed. So if you're not getting this game, please go in and log in again to WTHU.org and click on Watch Live video stream. Here goes Catoctin running off tackle to the right side. 7-yard gain on the carry. Jake Baker with the carry.
And Baker was able to find a good hole there. Catoctin offensive line opened up. Nice hole there. He was able to squeeze through, do his thing.
Cougars with their opening possession of this first quarter. Come out in a wing set. Pitch the deep back around right tackle. Couple of yards, still moving the piles a little bit. It's going to be third and short. Call it third and one for the Cougars as they just get into running the ball left, running it right. Simple vanilla.
It's trying to start a tempo, it looks like, just running the ball. Hopefully just get these short yard run gains.
Run formation, power T for the Cougars. Straight ahead, quarterback keeper. The pile moves. Good penetration. He gets the spot. First down yardage.
Stay there. Stay there. Get Max in right now. Get Max in right now. Get Max in. Now send.
It looks like they called him short by a couple of inches on that one. They did not move the chains, so Catoctin immediately trots their kicking unit, punting unit out on the field, and they go three and out. They're going to have to punt to Boonesboro deep. High snap.
Oh, high snap.
Can't handle it. Pulls it down and kicks it. It's a squib kick. Boonesboro's going to get it. On the 15-yard line of Catoctin, and we knew this was going to be a hard, slippery football to handle.
Boonesboro, we're coming to ball. Number 8, Chase Harrington.
He ran off.
All right, Boone. Now we had 11. Excellent field position. He ran off. Tormund ran off. Looking to the side. Tormund ran off. Looks like a little confusion on the part of the offense for the Warriors. There's the, no, he was counting on the field. There's a clean ball. They just tossed down on the field there. Nice drive ball. Keep drying them off out there because the field is just completely soggy wet. You look there on the 40-yard line, I see a puddle.
Yeah, they
another
wide.
One.
Spread. Two by one. Two by one, sniffer.
On Boonesboro.
Where is it?
And have a first down for the Cougars.
And now they're going to march him back. That's ridiculous.
Let's see what the call is on that.
Yeah, two by one. Who's this?
Right down the play.
So it's going to be, now I've got some confusion as the referees come out on the field. The side judge wants to talk to the head referee.
Who's to the left of you, CI?
And they call sideline infraction warning.
Sideline warning.
Against Boonesboro is the call.
Right next to you.
Definitely not.
That's fine. First down for the good.
Here we go.
So
two by one,
get the ball back.
Shepard.
And there we've got a motion call on the Cougars. Don't ask me what happened.
And flag down again.
How did they get the ball back?
I'm not sure. False start against the Cougars. Back on 5 yards.
All right. So So that'll move the Cougars back five. We've got a pretty sloppy game, not just on the field, but in the execution as well. First and 15 now for the Cougars.
Again, the same thing like brings them out of the huddle. Quarterback now.
Split right, split left. Pistol formation, wing right. Michael wants to pass. Looking deep. Got a man, stops, caught all the way down and driven out of bounds.
Number three, Eli Pryor.
On the 7-yard line. Rich is going to get him pissed off too. He's giving him too much room. Catch. Not sure who that was.
Going to play by eight. Peter Hernandez. And
no, he's out injured.
24, Connie Youngman.
And that's going to hurt the Cougars losing. They got a good player like
him. Let's swear. The inside. One of their times. Okay.
Ball 5 to 37-yard line of the Warriors. First down and 10.
Twins.
First and 10. Michael brings them out. Empty backfield motion. Hands off.
Quarterback.
No, he fakes it. Pulls it in straight ahead on the keeper.
Number 5, Christian Michael, straight ahead. Stopped on the play by 80, Chase Fowler, Charman.
He's so deceptive with that.
27. Ivan.
Yeah, I understand in his freshman year, he was there, he took some snaps. And
Ivan
there.
Wants
switching
to go.
Personnel. Softball, you have won the job.
Dark. Now it's twins.
All right, quickly off the line of
Sniffer. Sniffer, stop. Right up
there. And the back straight ahead. Baker.
And
the secondary
eight,
still on his feet.
Jake Baker straight ahead.
Four on the carry. It's
going to
be third.
Number 11, Jake White. And number 50, James Haney. Third down, one to go for the Cougs.
There it is. Still, straight up, straight ahead.
Cougs break the huddle.
Sniffer this way to the twins.
Slot left. Wing in the motion. Change the side. Wings up on the right side.
Number 8, Jake Baker. Straight ahead.
Keep him. Keep him. No punt. Keep him.
Stop on play number 50.
Max for brain pain now.
Score of the first down. Bring about fourth down for the Cougars.
Giving
them two.
Giving
them the whole drive. Bobby Alpelli, it'll be first
down for the Cougars. Tell Max. Keep an eye over top, Max.
Cougars break out of the hole.
Toss right.
All right.
Good morning.
Number 8, Jim Baker.
The right tackle. The legs on that, Will. Yeah, our backside guys are just stopping and watching. We got to come get the legs.
Stop by number 27, Ivan Walker-Zaguri.
Okay, twins this way. Two by two. Doubles. Middle of the field. They're going to run straight ahead on you. Quarterback. Yes.
Quarterback keeper number 5, Christian Michael. Good for a short game. Yes. Stopped by number 50, James Haney. And 80, Chase Carmen.
Hey.
Brings up third down for the
Cougars.
Swings.
Get out here, Max. Okay, now Biggie's out here. There you go. Go on, Max. See you, dude.
Pass complete number 4, Travis Field. Stop by number 30, Ethan Holabinka. And 44, Reed Gordon. That's good for a first down. Come on, you gotta stop him now. Baltimore's on the
4-yard. Right, it was a sure catch. Had the receiver had no defenders within 3 yards of him either direction.
Cougars first and goal. They pitch. Ooh, met right at the line of scrimmage and driven back. He lost a couple on that, Will.
Yeah, at least two. Definitely lost at least a few yards.
Apologize, we had some trouble with our video feed audio. We've got it fixed now for all of you people watching. That'll bring up second and goal for the Cougars with the ball spotted right on the 5-yard line as they shuttle the play in the huddle from the sideline. Split right, double wing set, empty backfield. Motion across, he fakes the jet sweep, pulls it, goes straight ahead, dives. He didn't get in, but he's down close to, let's call it the mark, looks like the 3-yard line. So give him a gain of 3 on the carry.
Third and goal. Probably see something similar here, I'm thinking.
Third and goal from the 3-yard line. We're definitely in 2-down territory here. Michael brings him out. Again, motion, this time. Caught in the backfield and dropped for a 4-yard loss.
Yep.
You're exactly right. They called the same keeper, but they jet sweeped. They motioned to the other side.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Now,
so Boonesboro defense not fooled on that one. Sniffed it out easily. As they shuttle in. Big play right here for the Boonesboro defense. Let's see if the Warriors can hold. Catoctin. Two wide receivers split wide. Michael looks like he wants to pass. Looking right. He throws the fade. Let's see the catch. Touchdown, Catoctin Cougars on the fade into the corner of the end zone. Unbelievable catch by that wide receiver over there. So the Cougars on fourth and goal punch it in on a fade to the wide receiver in the right end, right corner of the end zone, Will.
Even the referees weren't sure about that one.
Yeah, it took him a moment.
Mm-hmm.
Here comes the 2-point conversion for the Cougars. Same formation. Motion. Quarterback keeper, he's in. He walks in standing up. Christian Michael with a 2-point conversion. And we've got an 8-0 Catoctin lead here at Catoctin High School. They draw first blood with 4:12 to go in the first quarter. We'll be right back after this important break.
David Salon is a sophisticated hair salon that will pamper you in a big city atmosphere with personalized small town service. Conveniently located in the Walkers Village Shopping Center in Walkersville, create the new you with one of our experienced, innovative stylists. David Salon will help you look and feel your absolute best. Color, waxing, facials, manicures, pedicures, and more. Men and women love David Salon. Call for an appointment today at 301-845-4050. That's 301-845-4050. Or check us out online at davidsalons.com. David's Salon is a proud sponsor of Frederick County High School Athletics.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Catoctin High School, the Cougars just drove it down the field, and they did it on a couple of timely penalties to move the chains. To score, and the 2-point conversion successful. It's 8-0. There's a squib kick up the middle, takes a wild bounce, it's in the air. Good fielding, good hands by that Boonesboro Warrior as he slides down. The Warriors have it with great field position on their own 41.
Now, that one, I wasn't sure about that. I wasn't sure who got on that one, but it was pretty clear,
Yeah, they slid down, and I mean, that's footing out there is just treacherous. All right. Warriors with their first possession here as they set the ball down. Referee having a little trouble getting his foot stuck in the mud. And now the back judge runs in. I don't know what he has to say there. They're having a little chat. Looks like they're talking to the center. And now they've picked up the ball and they're looking at it. They want another ball. They've turned the sidelines.
Get our ball in there. Get our,
and they want another ball in from the sidelines. So the referee is asking for another ball. Not sure what they saw or what the problem was, but they will. They're over on the sideline trying to get one in there. Kind of caught the ball guy off guards there, didn't they?
Yeah. Well, this is a game everyone should have seen coming. I mean, with the forecast. Should have been better prepared for this one.
Well, actually, and truthfully, I thought they might postpone it till tomorrow, because tomorrow it's supposed to clear up, and it was pouring down rain all day here in Thurmont. Okay, here we go. We're set. Motion. Pitch to the deep motion back around the left end. Got some penetration, and he's knocked for a 1-2 yard loss. As they sniffed out, that right defensive end sniffed out that motion sweep.
And that was great containment by the defensive end and the outside linebacker to keep that play from beating the edge and going the distance.
Here we go. Boonesboro quickly out to the line of scrimmage. Slot goes into motion slowly, cuts up field, fakes it, rolls to his right, got some pressure, hits the guy on a quick out, it's caught, and immediately tackled and driven out of bounds, but he got a couple on that. Let's give him 5 yards on the catch, Will.
Now, that actually looked like it was going to be an option play, but instead it's one of those RPOs we've been hearing about a lot, a run-pass option, where the quarterback pulled up, and instead of pitching it to the out man, he just tossed it to the first guy he saw.
All right. LaRoche brings him back up. He's got one receiver split left. Wing right, two backs. Motion across the formation by the wing. Hand off to the lone back in the deep. Straight ahead. It's a simple little fullback trap. Give him a couple on the carry. That's going to bring up 3rd and 3. With the ball right just short of the midfield stripe marked at the 47-yard line, still in Boonesboro territory. Check that. That's 4th down, 4th and 3 for the Warriors. So they're going to punt it away. No one back deep for Catoctin. They're just going to let him go. He angles it for the sidelines, takes a good Warriors bounce, and rolls all the way down to the 17-yard line is the mark. The Cougars will take over for their second possession of this first half, 1st and 10 from their own 17.
Now, if I'm Boonesboro and I see that they don't have any true returner back there, I almost wonder if you take a timeout and audible at the line, actually.
With 3 yards to go, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a good thought. Cougars huddle up right on their own 10-yard line, break the formation out to the line of scrimmage. Pistol. Four receivers split wide, spread formation for Catoctin. Quarterback keeper straight ahead, big hole up the middle. He runs up for 6-yard gain.
Seeing that quarterback keeper a lot tonight. Maybe the 3rd or 4th time they've run that in 2 possessions?
Give him 5 on the mark. Ball spotted at the 22-yard line. 2nd and 5 for the Cougars. Here come the Cougars, line of scrimmage. They got 2 receivers on both sides of the formation. They're going to pass, looking deep. Got a man, they throw it up on the fade. He comes back, adjusts to it. And it's incomplete. So the ball falls short. It was just a little short, and the receiver tried to adjust, Will.
But he almost had that. He almost, but almost doesn't bring in catches.
So the Cougars shuttle three players into the huddle with the play. That brings up third and five for Catoctin. Catoctin sitting on an 8-0 lead here in the first quarter. Two receivers split wide. The back slipped in the backfield. He took the handoff, but he couldn't get any traction. He's going to lose a couple. So there's that footing issue.
Mm-hmm. It's almost impossible to plant your foot and make a cut in this kind of saturated, wet ground.
And right in that spot between the, let's say between the, really right over the 20 and 25 yard line, it is a mess.
Mm-hmm. It's just one big quagmire right there.
Punting units on the field. There's a good snap. They get the kick away. It's a good kick. It bounces at the 45, out to the 50 where it's fielded. He runs to his right, got an open field on his 40 down to the 37-yard line. So good return. Let's call that a 12-yard return by the Warriors.
Great personal effort right there by the return man. Trusting in himself that he can make a play in this wet weather.
So Boonesboro comes out of this one with great field position. Really, that's a net 15-yard punt. They've got four receivers on the left side. They hand off to the deep off left tackle. Fakes it, almost picked. It's caught all the way down to the 15, 10, all the way in. Touchdown, Boonesboro. And the receiver tried to cut under the ball, and he missed it, and the receiver makes the catch.
I believe that was number 23, Isaiah Barnhart on the reception and touchdown.
So immediately Boonesboro answers with their own pass for a touchdown. 8-6 now as Boonesboro brings their offensive unit out for a two-point conversion. Motion, pitch toss to the right side, got a clean lane, caught from behind. Great saving tackle by number 20. I can't read his number. There's too much mud on his jersey.
Already.
Could you see that?
No, I could not make that out.
His whole right side of his jersey was just solid brown. All I saw was a 2-something. So the Cougars hold on the two-point conversion and keep the lead at 8-6 here on a minute 12 in the first quarter, as both teams huddle up and will prepare for the second kickoff of this first quarter. So we've already got 14 points on the board, Will. You think we're looking at a horse race here?
Yeah, whatever team has the ball last. I see this being as a really tight back and forth game.
Yeah, but this is a game where there's going to be a lot of turnovers, a lot of fumbles, maybe a couple of slips, and that one was one that went the other way. The defender cut under, and he had the play on the ball, but he just couldn't get to the ball because he couldn't get the footing. All right, Boonesboro will kick off to the Cougars now, right in the middle of the muck. There's the run-up. Short kick up the middle, taken at the 22, out to the 25, 30, still on his feet. Tackled and dropped at the 33-yard line. Cougars will take over first and 10. So far, unbelievably, in the mud, we would expect this to be a running duel, and it's been a passing game. Both scores on passes.
Yeah, it looks like Michael is continuing his success from last week when he put up over 315 yards and 3 touchdowns against Brunswick. Looks like he's trying to continue that success.
Long huddle for the Cougars. Now they come out to the line of scrimmage. 107 to go in the quarter. Michael brings him out. Wing right. Slot motion. Over his hand. He picks it up. He rolls to his left. He's going to take the sack all the way back at the 17. So a high snap over Michael's head is going to cost the Cougars about 12 yards.
That's all the center on that one. Even if Michael was able to rein that in, he would it would be an automatic sack almost.
So the ball is marked all the way back at the 18-yard line. They've got to get to the 43. So that's second and 25 for the Cougars. Michael, straight drop, wants to pass, got some pressure, scrambles out to the left, wide open field, breaks one tackle and hurdles himself over the player all the way out to the 45-yard line.
And that was a great job by Catoctin's backs to recognize that Michael was running out of the pocket and to switch into run block mode.
Gain of 18 on the scramble. That'll bring up third and 7. With the ball right on the nose of the ball, right on the 35-yard line. And that's the end of the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen, with the Catoctin Cougars leading it 8-6 here at Catoctin High School. You're listening to the 1A West Regional Semifinals on Cool 1450 AM. We'll be right back after this important message.
The Catoctin Wildlife Preserve has over 600 exotic animals spread over 50 acres in the foothills of the Catoctin Mountains just off Route 15 south of Thurmont. Enjoy our personal style of education and exhibits with interactive touch and feel opportunities. Open throughout November, weekends only from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Check out our website, CatoctinWildlifePreserve.org, or call us at 301-271-3180. That's 301-271-3180. Catoctin Wildlife Preserve. Amazing new animal friends are waiting to meet you today.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Both teams are on the field. The Cougars have the ball. We switch ends of the field. Third and 7 for Catoctin with the ball right on the 35-yard line in Cougars territory as Michael brings him out. Four receivers split wide. He wants to pass. Three-step drop. Got some pressure. Has to scramble. Steps up in the pocket. No one there. He runs for the first down. Still on his feet. Breaks one tackle. Evades the tackle and takes it all the way down to the 42-yard line. Great run where he scrambled again.
I actually think that was a designed run.
You think it was a draw?
Yeah, it looked later like he was just faking his reads than anything else.
I saw the pocket collapse on him, and he squirted out of it, so I think they were getting ready to pass on that. Here we go. Hand off to the deep back, straight ahead, off tackle. Got a couple on the carry. Let's call it second and 7. Michael brings him out line of scrimmage. Spread formation, wants to pass, throws it out, a quick little caught, and it's dropped. That ball bounced on the ground. I mean, he threw it right at his feet. He just kind of lobbed it in there. It was a soft one.
He didn't get a good handle on that ball when it was snapped to him. It looked like it didn't get any kind of spin in the air. It just kind of floated over.
So once again, Catoctin facing a third and 7. As they bring out from the line of scrimmage, right there in the muck on the 40-yard line. Wants to pass. Straight drop. Got plenty of time. Throws it up into the coverage. No good.
And I believe the receiver on that one was just lost in the lights.
You're absolutely right. Looking back up towards the quarterback, he lost it in the lights. Quickly, we got four right. A quick little screen. It's that ball's on the ground. Oh my goodness! They're going to want to review that one. That was a backward. That was a lateral. It bounced. The Boonesboro player picked it up, and the referee blew it dead. From our vantage point, that ball was behind the quarterback on the throw.
Yeah, definitely.
So they're going to call it. Let's see what the call is on the field. So the ball boy was still on the field, so it's no play, dead ball. So the Cougars get one heck of a break on that. So here it is, fourth and seven. Spread formation for Michael. Here they come. Straight drop, Michael on a quick little screen. Cannot get around, and it's going to be a turnover on downs as they only get about two on the quick little screen play to the wing receiver.
He was able to get to the edge, but the pursuit was too much.
So the Cougars turn it over on downs, and Boonesboro will come up with it in their own territory on the 38-yard line, first and 10. As DeRocher brings him out. Motion across the formation. Handoff on the jet sweep. Got a man, gets buried on that corner. Caught from behind, breaks the tackle. Still on his feet, driving, legs churning. They're going to give him four on the carry. Good stiff running by that Warriors back.
And that was, again, Isaiah Barnhart, the young man who scored the touchdown earlier.
Second and six for the Warriors. They go two receivers split wide, one in the slot, wing left. The wing goes in motion and then sets behind the quarterback, handoff to the deep back off right tackle. The quarterback pulls it in on the fake, and he's caught in the backfield for a sack.
Yeah, the Cougars defenders on that one did not really fall for the fake. They were able to read that and make the sack pretty quick.
So all the way back to the original line of scrimmage, that'll bring up third and 10 for the Warriors. With the ball back on the 48. Catoctin leads this one in the second quarter, 8-6. DeRocher brings him out. Motion across the back. Pitch. Fakes it, reverse, counters, caught in the backfield, spins and turns and dragged ahead for about a yard. They're going to mark him at the 39, so give him a yard on the carry. That's going to bring up fourth and nine, Will.
Now, on that one, it was a counter. They had the kickout man blocked, but he beat them back inside and was able to get back into the hole. Was able to stop the ball carrier.
So Boonesboro brings their punting unit out on the field, and again, now Catoctin sends somebody back deep. Good snap, steps up into it, gets a nice kick away. Fair catch is signaled, but he can't take it, and it drops right in a puddle and stops dead on the spot as the nose of the ball just kind of just buries into the mud right there.
Have to change that one out.
So Cougars get it back. What we're seeing now is a back-and-forth seesaw as the offenses are unable to convert and move the chains in this last couple of possessions. Cougars break out to the huddle. 8:42 to go in the half. They lead it 8-6. Power formation. Pitch to the deep back around left end. Pushing through the pile, good seam, good movement, gain of five on the carry.
And that was good ball carrier vision on that one. Was able to find the hole, able to get a good, decent chunk of yards. Not too little, not too much. Keep this drive going.
Second and five, ball spotted on the 40-yard line as the Cougars are staying in that power formation, sort of almost like a wishbone. Same play, right off left tackle, straight ahead. This time met at the line of scrimmage, and he falls ahead for a yard. So that's going to bring up third and three.
Yeah, they're running old formations from when I played back here.
Yeah, it looks like a wishbone,
doesn't
it? Yeah,
it does.
Now, they typically have been running a T formation, but now they're taking that fullback and cheating him up a half a yard into the wishbone. Same formation. Michael under center. Michael slips, then he's going to want to pass. Got a man.
Yes.
Beautiful play by the defender there to break that pass up. Ball incomplete.
He almost ran his route for him just a few yards shorter.
He stepped right in front of it and put out that left hand and batted the ball down. So the Cougars drive stalls, and they'll have to punt it away.
Get in the middle, Landon. Law. Move up, Landon. Move up, Landon. Move up.
There's the punt.
Good.
Nice punt. Taken right at the 31. Fair caught. No return. He had no one near him. Not sure. Did you even see him signal for the fair catch?
No, but it was almost as if he didn't trust his own.
I don't think
catch that one.
I don't think he wanted to run with it.
Yeah.
All right, that's okay. Ball's on the 32-yard line, first and 10. Call it 31 for Boonesboro, where they take over now. Cougars with an 8-6 lead here in the second quarter. DeRocha brings him out. Motion across the backside, and then he sets in the backfield. He turns and hands off to him straight ahead. Met in the backfield and no gain on the play.
There were no running, there were no holes, no seams, or anything for him to get through on that one.
Interesting call on that. They motion the back across. He does not continue the motion, but sets in the backfield, and then they hand it off to him. So it looked like that left linebacker was keying on him. Now they work it the other way. They hand off to that back on the motion this time, and he runs around the right end where he's met for a one-yard gain. Give him three on the forward progress. Ball all the way out to the 35-yard line, where it'll be third and 7 for the Warriors.
Now, what do you see them pulling off at this?
I think they got to. I think they really have to pass right here.
Yeah, definitely. I think this is definitely a passing down.
And they're showing a run formation, so let's see what they call out of that. There's the motion again. Into the backfield, he sets. Hand off again, off right tackle. He pulls it in, wants to pass. He slips and falls, but he gets the ball out. Incomplete pass. So the quarterback on the read option fakes the handoff to that motion setback. And then he goes to pass, but he falls as he delivers.
Pulled the smart, he made the smart play by getting rid of the ball instead of taking a loss.
Taking the sack, yeah. So that brings the punting unit. So right now, this second period, second quarter, nothing but a battle of punters. Good snap, got it away. Good kick, line drive, bounces at the 45, takes a Warriors roll, picked up by a Cougar, runs around the left end, still on his feet. Oh, met right there at the bench and driven out of bounds. They're going to say he stepped out on the far side. Let's see what the spot is. Looking for that spot on the other side. They're marking it in Cougars territory on the 47. So he tried to tippy-toe down that sideline and must have got a little of the white. So the Cougars take over now.
And he's got to call Daquan off.
8-6 lead at 6:06 to go in that first half. They break the huddle, split two receivers out to both sides of the formation. Spread offense. For Catoctin. Michael in the shotgun.
Squeeze trip.
Wants to take the option, read option. He pulls it down. He reads that linebacker went for the pitch. And so Michael kept it and ran off tackle for about 8.
Made a good read on that one. Was able to get up to give them about 2nd and 2. Or no.
No, they didn't give him a good spot on that. It looked like he got good yardage on it, but he must have had a knee down because they only marked him off on 4, so call it 2nd and 6. Same formation for the Cougars. Michael options the other way. Around the left end, got a good block, but a great tackle from that right corner, or the right safety as he comes in and stops him.
Stopped him right before he could get the edge.
4 yards on the carry. That'll bring up third and one. Maybe a long one or maybe two. Far side of the field. Ball spotted now in Boonesboro territory on the 44-yard line. Cougars staying in that same spread offense. High snap, keeper by Michael, straight ahead. First down yardage into the second level and all the way down to the 37-yard line. They move the chains.
That Catoctin offensive line got a good push there. Able to open up a good seam for Michael. He was able to run right up the middle.
Cougars have a fresh set of downs now with the ball spotted on the 37 as Michael brings them out. Sticking with the spread all the way on this possession, this series. He wants to pass. Three-step drops, plants, flings it up, got a man wide open, caught at the 20, breaks the tackle, drags him all the way down to the 7-yard line. And that ball floated forever and a day, didn't it?
And that was a great job by the wide receiver.
Number four.
To come back, almost making an outfielder move.
Yeah, that was Travis Fields. He was very patient on that because that ball had interception written all over it. So first and goal for the Cougars on the Boonesboro 7 as Michael brings them out. This time they shift into the double wing set. Motion wing. Jet sweep around the left side. Michael pulls it down on the read and drives straight ahead for two.
We've seen at least one quarterback keeper per drive.
The jet sweep was wide open. Let's see if they come back to it. Same formation. Double wing. Motion to the other way. Nope, he options out, takes it straight ahead, drives all the way down to the two. So Michael's sticking with it. He's going to run it himself. Christian Michael on the carry. This Catoctin Cougars quarterback is big enough that he can serve as, you know, one of the three backs in that running formation.
Reminds me a lot of the 2009 starting quarterback that won the state championship, Dylan May. Had a lot of speed, was able to make good moves in the open field.
Handoff on the counter, straight ahead, dances through and into the end zone. Touchdown, Catoctin Cougars! So the Cougars punch it in on a counter right there. Good call. As Boonesboro was reading sweep all the way. So the Cougars able to put another six up on the board with 3 minutes to go in the first half. They break out for the two-point conversion now. Going to throw the fade up in the air, and there's an interference penalty flag between the receiver and the defender. Let's see who gets the hanky.
I believe that's offensive pass interference. It almost looked like he was hugging the defender.
Let's see. If that's true, they'll wave it off. No signal yet. Pass interference, defense. So the Cougars will have another shot at the two-point conversion on the interference call. Wishbone formation showing power all the way. Cougars want to punch this in. Quarterback keeper off tackle. In he goes, and they convert. So the Cougars jump out to a 16-6 lead here with just slightly under 3 minutes to go on the clock. We'll step aside for a break and be right back.
MedOne Pharmacy is the largest locally owned and operated pharmacy in Frederick County. MedOne Pharmacy has four locations in Brunswick, Emmitsburg, Middletown, and Thurmont to provide you with convenience, experience, service, tradition, and value. MedOne Pharmacy. Check out their website at MedOnePharmacy.com. That's M-E-D-O-N-E Pharmacy.com today. Or for more information, call them at 301-271-2223.
MedOne Pharmacy is a proud sponsor of Frederick County Public School Athletics.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. With 3 minutes to go in this first half, the Cougars have tacked on another 8 on the board. 16-6 is our score here in the 1A West Regional Semifinal. The Cougars will kick off now, left to right. On your radio dial to Boonesboro as they get a dry ball in. And they spot it right on the 40-yard line. Here we go.
They didn't move at all.
Squib kick right up the middle, right through the hands of one warrior. Another slides and falls on it, and it's downed. Let's see what the spot is. It's going to mark it right at the 29-yard line. Boonesboro ball, first and 10. So we had a punting duel there in that first, beginning of that first part of the second quarter, and then Catoctin finally able to push it in. Let's see what Boonesboro can do with it as they come out. Two receivers split. They send one in motion. He cuts up field. They want to pass. Rolling to his left. Stops, sets. He throws it across the middle. Too far, just throwing out a little too far to the receiver here.
And it looked like a defender got his hand on that, was able to tip it.
Maybe, maybe not. Couldn't tell from this angle, but that was intended for number 87 for Boonesboro. DeRocher brings him out. Two receivers. They got wing right, slot left, split left. There's the motion. The wing back sets in the backfield again. They pitch to that wing back, and he tries to cut it up. Whoa, what a great tackle. Number 23, Barnhart, comes flying in out of nowhere and makes the tackle.
That was great flow by the linebackers to be able to read, watching the backfield and read where that play was going. They snuffed that out almost instantly.
They lose a yard on the carry, bringing up third and 11 now as the ball spotted on the 34. Two receivers split wide. DeRocher hands off to the left halfback, wants to go around the right side, met at the line of scrimmage. He gets about a yard on the carry, and then he's immediately met by that left tackle and dragged down.
There was nothing there on that play.
So that's fourth down coming. The punting unit trots out on the field, and the Warriors go three and out.
Did Daquan come out and land it in? Okay, there he is. Get on the line, Landon.
Punter standing back on his own 20. Eli Fry back deep for the Cougars. He kicks a squib kick up the middle, but it takes a good Warriors bounce, and then it dies right at the 44-yard line in Cougars territory, where Christian Michael will bring him out to take over first and 10.
Do you think they'll be able to repeat their success from the last season?
I think we're seeing a little bit of a momentum swing here. If you want the truth, we've got a minute 31 to go in the half with the Cougars up 16-6. I don't know if that's enough time in these conditions to move that ball 55 yards down the field.
You got 10, Will. Who's your safety?
And the Cougars definitely don't have a field goal kicker, so. Let's see what happens. Now we've got timeout on the field, a little confusion there, and we'll step aside for our next break.
Are you sick of paying bank fees just to talk to someone? Want to get out of the big banking world and be more than just an account number? Woodsboro Bank is committed to banking that truly serves the needs of their customers and Frederick County. You'll get personal small-town customer service at their 7 local offices. And with no-fee use of Woodsboro Bank's ATMs and all 32,000 all-point ATMs nationwide, you'll get big city convenience. Woodsboro Bank offers versatile checking accounts designed to accommodate your specific needs. Business owners can also appreciate the convenience and revenue building power of Woodsboro Bank's many commercial services. Discover the many advantages of local-owned community banking.
Visit Woodsboro Bank at their new location on Frederick Road next to Mountain Gate Family Restaurant, or call them at 301-271-4944.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. The Cougars on their first down got stuffed right at the line of scrimmage. So they've got second and 10 here as they come out in the spread. Michael in the pistol, looks quickly to the right, fakes the pass, and then pulls it down and scurries ahead for about 4 on the carry.
Not much of a gain on that one. That looked like a design run again. Michael.
Yeah, he 4 yards is good. I mean, I'll take 4 yards on first down any day of the week. But what he did was he looked right, looked off the defense to the right, and then he pulled it down and ran straight off right in the A-gap. So again, we've got a timeout on the field. We'll take another break.
The Catoctins are beautiful this time of year, and there's no better way to soak them in than with lunch or dinner at the Shamrock Restaurant. Fried fresh oysters have returned. Have some this week. Savor the Shamrock's bountiful hand-breaded shrimp dinner or well-prepared prime rib cut, both with vegetable and salad, only $18.95. Don't forget to stop by and order one of the Shamrock's daily lunch specials. And of course, weekends are filled with fine fare and music. Come to the Shamrock on US 15 in Thurmont or online at ShamrockRestaurant.com. Closed Tuesdays.
All right, welcome back. Catoctin has it in the spread. Straight drop. Michael wants to pass. Looking deep. Throws it way up in the air. No one there. Absolutely no one there at all, Will. That must have been a busted route.
Yeah, that was a lot of miscommunication between the wide receiver and quarterback on that one.
So that's going to bring up 4th and 6 for the Cougars as the punting unit comes onto the field. And they're looking to win this battle of field possession. So I told you, I said, you know, there's only a couple of, a minute and a half left when they first took over possession. Now we're down to 38 seconds, and they're going to punt it away and try to pin Boonesboro deep. Good punt. Take it at the 18. Out to the 20, 25, drag down to the 30. So Boonesboro will have it with about 35 seconds on the clock, and they'll get a couple of shots at trying to get something down. They're going to try to move down deep. They're going to have to go upstairs.
A lot of, you'll probably see vertical passing situations right here.
So let's see what they dial up. Coach Anders has been there many, many times. This is their 4th playoff appearance in as many years. Looking to the sideline, they've got the signal now. They split one receiver out wide. They got a double wing on the left. They send one of the wings in motion. He sets in the backfield. Then he goes into motion again. They fake the pitch and go on the reverse, on the counter. He's got some running room into the secondary, still on his feet. First down yardage. So they move the chains. Nifty little play. I like that.
That was great vision by the ball carrier. He made a couple defenders miss. Did a really good job on that one. Was able to plant, cut, and make some defenders miss on this sodden field.
So they get into a good place now where the ball's not quite so muddy in the mud there. With it spotted on the 41-yard line in Boonesboro territory, they send two receivers out wide, and then they shift into the quarterback. They pitch to that back. He's caught in the backfield, breaks the tackle, and then he's caught right at the line of scrimmage, spun around and dragged down. So his forward progress is going to mark him right at the line of scrimmage as the clock runs out. And that's it. That's the end of the first half here at Catoctin High School with the Catoctin Cougars 16 and the Boonesboro Warriors 6. We'll be back for a quick first half wrap-up in just a moment.
Where do you get your real-time information? News, weather, traffic, school delays, and cancellations. At Cool 1450 AM, one of our most important resources is FrederickScanner.com. Live traffic cams, weather cams, city and county resources, police, fire and rescue. Anyone living, working, or traveling in and around Frederick should bookmark FrederickScanner.com on their PC or go to their Facebook page and download the mobile app today. FrederickScanner.com, a live information window to Frederick County.
Cool 1450 AM WTHU, where Frederick County High School sports and the greatest hits of all time come to play.
Do you like good music? I remember when rock was young.
After the game, keep it here 24-7 on the station that rocks the Catoctins with the greatest hits of all time. Cool 1450 AM WTHU and online anytime at WTHU.org.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're at halftime at Catoctin High School. And Will, what's your take on that first half? What do you see as the keys to the first half in this game?
Well, Boonesboro's going to need Boonesboro's relying heavily on Isaiah Barnhart. And I think Catoctin's kind of noticing that. So they've been picking up on it. Except for a few key plays, he's been pretty well contained.
All right, I've got some scores coming in now for you. Fort Hill is leading Southern Garrett 38-0. Up there in a game that one of these two teams is going to have to play. No score on the Oakdale side of it. Let's check our feed for Linganore. Linganore leading 38-0 with 6:41 left in the half. Ryan Lay hits Joey Felton for 48-yard score, so Linganore is way, they're going to have a running clock in the second half. And finally, let's look at the Damascus game. Damascus, of course, nothing on the Damascus side that came in yet. And then our last feed comes in from South Hagerstown. And we've got nothing from South Hagerstown. All right. So, you know, the way I see it, that first half was really, it was a battle of field position. It was a punting duel. The only team that's been able to successfully move the ball has been the Cougars. Boonesboro had that one quick strike on the deep pass, but they've not been able to get any kind of rhythm or any series of downs moving the chains going. And Catoctin, frankly, has only done it once.
Yeah. Boonesboro needs, like I said earlier, they need to rely on Isaiah Barnhart. I think he'll be the key for this game. He's one of their leading backs coming into this season. Has over 800 yards.
Wow. Well, you know, Barnhart, he is their leading back, but they've got three really good halfbacks in that duel, don't they?
Yeah, I'm seeing Christ. He's also a really good back, and then their fullback Holobinko. Yeah,
that's a hard one.
That one, yeah.
Holobinko, he's a good lead blocker, tough runner up the middle, and then they've got Chris, their speed guy. So you know, this game is anybody game to win. There's only, you know, 18-6. It's a 12-point game. It's a three-score game. So all right, we'll step aside for a halftime break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back in just a few minutes for some great high school football here. Playoff football on Cool 1450 AM WTHU.
Gettysburg Auto Auction is looking for additional buyers for our increased car volume. So if you're in the market for a new used car, try this little auction. Gettysburg Auto Auction continues to have the highest customer satisfaction and lowest fees of any auto auction. And our exclusive bid drive-by program allows you to drive your car before you buy it. If you missed out on Gettysburg Auto Auction's Thursday night sale, stop by on Friday for our Leftover Friday sale, where any vehicle still available can be bought on the spot. Gettysburg Auto Auction is located on Route 15 at the Maryland-Pennsylvania line, the Steinware exit. For directions and a sampling of upcoming vehicles, visit GettyAuto.com. Gettysburg Auto Auction, the little auction with a new start time of 6 p.m. and looking for additional buyers to go with our influx of vehicles.
For over 30 years, the McLeaf family has been bringing the tradition of home country cooking and fun to our region at the Mountain Gate Family Restaurant. Dine in at the restaurant or catering on the go. And for special events, holidays, and weddings, check out their Green Grove Gardens in Greencastle, Pennsylvania. Located just off Route 15 in Thurmont, Mountain Gate Family Restaurant features a huge buffet with something for the whole family. Breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Mountain Gate Family Restaurant is famous for their delicious homemade cooking, their fresh desserts, and their unique gift shop. Mountain Gate Family Restaurant is not just a place to eat, but an experience. Their renowned Thursday evening Gospel Sings features some of the greatest groups around. And don't forget, with Thanksgiving right around the corner, now's the time to make a reservation to enjoy the finest homestyle holiday dinner anywhere. Call 301-271-4373. That's 301-271-4373.
Catoctin High School.
Go Warriors! Go Warriors!
Clarkson High School would like to thank the Thelma Ambulance Company for being in attendance at tonight's game. The organization has always been more than willing to give their time and service to make these activities safer for our student-athletes. Please support our volunteer and fire rescue organization as they are a valuable community resource. And the Clarkson High School would like to thank Mark Chet from Physical Therapy for providing athletic training coverage for this evening's contest. Physical Therapy has over 70 locations where you live, work, and play, including facilities in Emmitsburg, Frederick, and Westminster. Physical Therapy is available for all ages. Visit Physical Therapy for your center point to recovery and good health. And the Unified Sports Program is selling the Stockton 50th anniversary ornaments tonight. These shatterproof ornaments will last through the years and reflect special memories. Get yours tonight in the concessions area. The Stockton softball team is having a crab cake dinner on Wednesday, November 14th from 5 to 8. Sit down dinner. Carry out available.
Only
17-14. Hell of that, the Emmitsburg Ambulance Building, 17701 Creamery Road.
Shift the second line, not the front line.
It includes two of Mrs. Davis's amazing
crab cakes. Shift the second line right.
Coleslaw, baked green beans, dinner roll, dessert, tea, and water. Now to get ready.
Where's Daquan? Move Daquan right. Move Pinky to the middle of the field. Get Pinky in the middle of the field. Move Daquan to the right.
And number four.
Keep going. Keep going, Daquan. Keep going.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Kickoff
was down
all
by
the way down to the 42-yard line.
Sorry, Wilbur.
Where the Boonesboro Warriors will take over first and 10.
Nathan Wharton, number 6 for the Warriors, down the ball. And first down and 10. Ball final on the 40-yard line.
Why didn't he go ahead and return it?
Pitch to the deep back. Slips and falls. Oh, my goodness. He did get back to the line of scrimmage. And then on second effort,
so it looks
number like
20,
progress was right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a yard. Yeah, they give him a yard on the spot. So
George
Gaines
on the play, brings up second down
Cougars
for the Warriors.
Cougars up 16-6 here. We have
stop
just
on the play, number
the
8,
quarter.
Dave Baker, 22, Cam Bumgarner.
So, rough footing down there in that mug pit, right there on that far hash mark.
Yeah, that's kickoff return. It's kickoff return. It's not hands.
Yes. Long count. Now they send motion across. Quarterback scrambles on the keeper to his right. First down yardage and then some out of bounds into the Catoctin sideline. Great play by Boonesboro.
Run out of bounds to number 3, Eli Fry.
The ball carrier's just short of the marker.
Let's see what the spot is. You're right. He is just shy. That's going to call it third and a foot with the ball just over the 50-yard line into Cougars territory. Quarterback sneaks straight ahead. He got it. 2 yards on the sneak, moves the chains.
That's just a matter of your offensive line beating their defensive line and then letting their quarterback find a little hole and sneak and get skinny.
Low man wins.
Ball spotted
the 46-yard line by the Cougars. First down and 10.
DeRocher brings him out. Looks over the defense. Sends a little motion across. Pitch to the deep back. Wide open. Nothing there on the end. And he's caught about halfway down. Let's call it 5 yards on the carry, but that was a nice looking play. They had Catoctin had no one out there in space on that right corner. That corner had to vacate that space to keep with the wide receiver as he ran the go pattern.
I believe that was a fake to their fullback, Holoblinko.
Quarterback looks at his wrist for the play. Low snap, it's on the ground. He's got to pick it up and scurry, and he slides down to take the 10-yard sack, call it 14 yards on the loss. That's going to take them all the way back into their own territory on the 49-yard line in Boonesboro territory. And that's just unfortunate because that is a symptom of the kind of football we have here today. Third and 13 now for the Warriors as they signal the play in from the sideline. DeRocher looks at his wristband, and he's set. Double wing formation. Shotgun, wing in motion. Hand off to the wing. He pulls it down and runs with it. Still on his feet into the second level and all the way down to the 40-yard line. Nice run. Give him 15 on the carry.
That was a great fake. That was a great fake. I was even fooled on that one.
So that's going to bring fourth and four as Boonesboro is going to go for it. Same formation, motion across. Hand off to the deep back, straight ahead, caught in the backfield and dropped. A bunch of blue jerseys in there for Catoctin. And the offense will take over on downs.
Couldn't get a number on who've got the first contact.
You can't get any numbers out there tonight. No. They're all brown uniforms now. Except for the couple of subs that have come in recently. I can see Hunter Grimes' jersey. He's about the only one on the field. Spread formation for the Cougars. Michael, quarterback keeper straight ahead. Breaks one tackle, surges and pushes the pile a little bit. Give him three on the carry. Give him four on the forward progress as the ball is spotted right at the 45-yard line in Cougars territory. Second and six for Catoctin.
And I got a feeling we're going to be seeing that a lot this half, just like last half.
Hey, if you get 4 yards on a carry, that's, you know, you only need... You only need three of those to move the chains.
Exactly.
Going to pass, looking right, throws it up on a go pattern, intercepted right into the hands of the defender. Perfectly played by the Boonesboro defender as he stayed just inside, turned his head around and looked back at the ball and made the INT.
And there was no interference on that. That was just great play by the defender.
So the first turnover of the game in the air as Boonesboro gets the pick. Let's see if they can capitalize on this turnover. They bring receivers out to the near side. DeRocher looks over this way. Look, he wants to throw a quick screen. He's got the man on the hookup screen. Caught, beautiful tackle. Shoestring tackle by number four, Travis Fields, coming up from that safety position.
Yeah, and that was great personal effort there. He did not let go. Just waited for the rest of his guys to come to finish up the tackle.
Second and 12 now for Boonesboro as they split two receivers to the wide. They motion and hand off. Rolling, the quarterback stumbles and slips, but he brings it down, first down yardage, and in to the 45-yard line where he's brought down. That'll move the chains. That was that same play again. The quarterback was wide open on that.
And he almost slipped up on that one. That almost was a loss.
Yeah, he did slip in the backfield in that mud spot right there, but good balance by DeRocher as he moves the chains and gives the Warriors a fresh set of downs. Double wing formation. Long snap count. There's motion. Fakes a handoff straight ahead. Fullback trap. Good for four. Number 30, just a quick fullback trap up the middle off the motion. And they get four. That'll bring up second and six. That's almost 5 yards on that. Let's see. Yeah, we'll call it second and six. Just shy of the midfield stripe, still in Warriors territory as the Rocher brings them out. There's a flag on the far side of the field. Motion is the call. Illegal motion on the Warriors. That'll cost them five.
I couldn't actually tell who moved on that one.
It had to be the far side judge threw the flag. It had to be somebody on the right side of the line. All right. Second and 10 now for Boonesboro. The ball back on the 45. Hand off to the motion back. No, he pulls it in and keeps it. Straight ahead, breaks the tackle, falls good. 8 yard run by DeRocher on the keeper. He's looking a little bit like Christian Michael, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. And that one was almost a busted play. They almost ran into each other on that one. The ball carrier and the quarterback.
So that'll bring up third and two for the Warriors. Using a lot of clock up here in this third quarter. We're down to 5:27. Catoctin leading at 18-6. Warriors with a good drive going here. Want to keep it going. There's the motion. Sets in the backfield. Hand off to the motion back straight ahead. Follows his blocker. Still on his feet. Right behind the motion back. Back to the original. No, it's right to the first down marker.
And I believe they got that.
Looks like he got it. I think they're going to measure. First down is the signal. So they motion the back into the backfield. He sets, and then he's the lead blocker through the C gap.
And that play was almost stopped in the backfield. Someone got a hand on the running back, but wasn't able to bring him down.
Fullback trap straight ahead. Spins, drives, breaks a block. Stays feet. It's a foot race for the end zone. Caught from behind and dragged down at the 17-yard line. Good running by that fullback, Holubinko. All the way down to the 17. This is a very nice drive by the Warriors as they are now in the red zone and threatening.
Let's see if this Catoctin defense can hold.
Motion, rolling to his right, wants to pass, looking, throws it, got a man wide open, caught, and into the end zone. Touchdown, Boonesboro! What a beautiful pass and catch.
That was
as DeRocher just dialed it up perfectly. The back sitting in the soft zone, caught it, 4 yards to take it in. And we've got ourselves a football game here. Boonesboro looking it over, deciding, let's see, I think they're going to kick the extra point. They're going to go for the PAT. There's the snap, the set, the kick is up, no good. He lined it right straight ahead and under the crossbar. So the score will stand at 16-12 here. With 4:30 to go in the third, we'll step aside for a break and be right back.
I perform for our high school choir director, who taught me to breathe from the diaphragm and sing from the heart.
Speech, debate, theater, music. The performing arts teach valuable life lessons that typically aren't taught in the classroom. They help high school students learn leadership skills that prepare them to enjoy more satisfying, productive lives.
Hey, I've got a question for you. Who will you perform for?
This message presented by the Maryland Public Secondary Schools Athletic Association and the high school in your community.
Ah!
right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Boonesboro on a very impressive drive. Patient, takes a lot of time off the clock, drives it all the way down and into the end zone on an 11-yard pass and catch to bring this game to within four. Catoctin leads it. 16-12. There's a squib kick down the middle. Catoctin picks it up straight ahead. Dropped at the 18-yard line. It'll be Cougars ball first and 10 from their own 18. So the Warriors squib kick it up the middle, try to get a little, maybe a good bounce or a little bust loose there, a little action their way. But Cougars put it away and maintain possession for Christian Michael. Michael brings him out. Spread formation. Straight ahead. Nothing there. Maybe a yard or two on the carry, but not much. Let's see what they got. Give him one on the forward progress to bring up second and 9 for the Cougars. Spread formation again for Michael. Looking over that defense from the shotgun. He wants to pass. Three-step drop. Pumps it. Throws. Oh, my goodness. Too far off the hands of the receiver. There's the late flag. Oh, boy. We've got an interference, and that was a close call, but a good call. He was hanging on the receiver as he reached out to catch it. I know they don't like that call, but... getting a dry ball out there. Let's see what the referee has to say about that. No, they're going to mark that one off against Catoctin. So they do. No, I take that back. They call it pass interference. They're saying that the defender made contact too early, interfered with the receiver's ability to stretch out on that ball, and Catoctin gets another break. First and 10, ball on the 35. Michael pitches to the back around the left end. Got one man to beat. He does. Shakes a leg, bruises it, drives out of bounds at the marker. First down.
He was able to get the edge on that play, and then once that happened, he was good for about 8-10 yards.
So a fresh set of downs. They move it out to the 45-yard line. First and 10, Cougars. So a crucial pass interference penalty against the Warriors keeps the Cougars' drive alive, because that was huge because of the momentum swing.
Yeah, they got lucky on that one, Catoctin did.
Michael, spread offense. Wants to pass, pulls it down and runs straight ahead into the second level. Spins, met by a defender, but he gets 6 on the carry. That'll bring up 2nd and 4. Good run by Christian Michael on a designed quarterback draw.
Yeah, I was was going to say that was a design when I didn't see anyone actually run any routes.
He waited long enough for the receivers to drag the secondary deep, and then he popped it through the line. Same formation for the Cougars. Motion. Go, 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 go. Hands off. No, he fakes it. Pulls it down. Wants to throw. Got a man. Caught. Beautiful catch. Holy mackerel. What a catch. I believe that was Travis Fields down here on the near side. Mr. Clutch himself. All the way down to the 26-yard line. And that was defended perfectly.
And he is indeed Mr. Clutch. He had two receiving touchdowns last week.
So Catoctin all the way down at the 27-yard line with a fresh set of downs, looking over the sideline for the play to be signaled in by Coach Grimes on the sideline, far sideline of the Cougars bench.
You're good with your boundary thing right here.
Spread formation. Shotgun. Michaels, one back, sends the motion. Fakes a handoff, wants to pass, pulls it down, throws a quick out. It's caught. Touchdown, Catoctin. He walks into the end zone. untouched. What a beautifully designed play. Just that fast, the Cougars come back and they strike at that lead.
Wow!
So all of that as a result of that interference penalty. Here come the Cougars for the two-point conversion now. Power wishbone formation. Michael under center. Tosses to the left halfback straight ahead. He's met. Second effort. He pushes right down to the goal line. He does not get in. So good defensive stand by the Boonesboro Warriors to keep that extra two off the board. And the Cougars go back to a 10-point lead, 22-12, with 2:19 to go in the third.
And right there, Catoctin went back to their old-school wishbone formation, running a, I want to say, if any of my old Catoctin Cougar teammates can correct me, I think it's a G6. But they weren't able to convert that one.
All right, we'll stick with you here. Try to get you some scores from around the league as the three Frederick County teams in the playoff in the 1A, 2A, and 3A West. Catoctin, Oakdale, and Linganore. Last check, all three in the lead. Both teams huddled up on the far side of the field. Good crowd here. The rain finally stopped, settled down a little bit. Not too cold. Oakdale jumped out to a 24-14 lead now over Liberty. At halftime, Damascus leading Century 21-3, and Linganore 45-0 against Blake at halftime.
So they will definitely have that running clock at the beginning of halftime for that game.
Here comes the run-up. Kick, squib kick up the middle, goes to 10 yards, and falling on at the 45, it'll be Boonesboro's ball, first and 10 with great field position.
Yeah, that they only have 55 yards to march. I mean, that was really good field position in Catoctin.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of that squib kick.
No.
I like it when you just kick it away and get it done. Pin them back and win the battle of field position.
I think they were hoping that it would bounce out of someone's hand.
Yeah, but they, you know,
you gotta kick it deep.
Right. Motion across, handoff, and caught in the backfield. Breaks the tackle, falls ahead for two. That was all second and third effort by that back. He was caught in the backfield for a 3-yard loss. Second and 9 now for the Warriors. They got 5 players over here on the near side looking at the coaches as they signal it in, and they're 2 yellow jackets down here, 2 yellow jacketed Warriors coaches with the signals. Motion across the formation, rolling to his right, wants to pass. This is the one they got a touchdown on before. Got a man deep. Caught.
Got it.
He got behind the secondary all the way down to the 5. What a great play, dialed up as they snuck that tight end down behind the secondary, the safety.
And he just forgot he was behind him.
And they flung it. 50-yard completion all the way down to the 5 for Boonesboro. First and goal for the Warriors. Split right, slot right. Boonesboro stops, looks over to the sideline. Now they go back to the set. DeRocher hands off to the straight back on the fullback trap. Nothing there.
Defense was not fooled on that one. They sniffed that out pretty quick.
Give him a yard on the carry. Ball on the 4-yard line now. First and goal. Excuse me, second and goal from the 4 for the Warriors. Cougars lead at 22-12 with 56 seconds to go in the third, but Boonesboro is threatening to close that lead again. Wing left. DeRocher up under center. sends motion into the backfield, turns, hands off to the up back, straight ahead, caught, dragged down, second effort, right to the goal line and stopped at the one.
Yeah, just short of that goal line.
Yeah, we're in two down territory. They can punch it in right here.
Absolutely.
I mean, the sneak gets it done at this point.
Just hand it to the quarter, or just snap it to the quarterback and hope he gets
no huddle. Quick hurry up. That's exactly what they do. They sneak it. He did not get it. Eight in the box stop him at the point of attack. So that's going to run out the third quarter. We'll go to a break, change ends of the field, and try. Boonesboro will have one down to punch it in from the 1 foot line. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. At the end of three quarters of action, the Catoctin Cougars lead at 22-12, but don't worry, Boonesboro is threatening.
Are you sick of paying bank fees just to talk to someone? Want to get out of the big banking world and be more than just an account number? Woodsboro Bank is committed to banking that truly serves the needs of their customers and Frederick County. You'll get personal small-town customer service at their seven local offices. And with no-fee use of Woodsboro Bank's ATMs and all 32,000 all-point ATMs nationwide, you'll get big city convenience. Woodsboro Bank offers versatile checking accounts designed to accommodate your specific needs. Business owners can also appreciate the convenience and revenue building power of Woodsboro Bank's many commercial services. Discover the many advantages of local-owned community banking.
Visit Woodsboro Bank at their new location on Frederick Road next to Mountain Gate Family Restaurant, or call them at 301-271-4944. That's 301-271-4944.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Boonesboro has the ball on the 1 foot line. It's fourth and goal, and we've got ourselves a classic goal line stand right here between the Warriors and the Cougars. Cougars with a 10-point lead as we go into the opening minutes of the fourth quarter here, and now we've got a timeout, official timeout on the field. Boonesboro calls timeout. And I think they just wanted to see what the Catoctin alignment looked like so they could dial up the right play for that.
Yeah, they could see what Catoctin has, then they can adjust accordingly.
I want to thank today's game sponsors for making this possible. Brownies Auto Care, Catoctin Wildlife Preserve, Cousins Ace Hardware of Thurmont, David's Salon, DentedToolbox.com, Gettysburg Auto Auction, Happy Dog Groomers, Shuff's Meat Market, and finally, our newest sponsor, Woodsboro Bank. Thank you for sponsoring this 1A West regional semifinal football playoff game here at Catoctin High School, where the Cougars have a 22-12 lead, but Boonesboro is determined to trim that lead back to four. Or maybe even two, if they get the two-point conversion, right? All right, here we go. DeRocher brings them out. Split right, slot right. Pistol formation, motion, straight ahead. They're running it. There's the signal. Touchdown, Boonesboro Warriors. They punch it in on fourth down. And boy, they needed all four of those downs to make it happen, didn't they?
And that was a really close one, too. It almost looked like the quarterback, I believe that was a quarterback sneak. I almost believe the quarterback didn't cross the plane.
So at 11:56 in the fourth, Boonesboro back on the board again quickly, trims the lead to four, and they'll come out for the two-point conversion now. A very crucial two-point conversion here.
Yeah, you have to go for two right here.
Little confusion on the offense as the players are trying to get the formation set. They're all looking around. Shotgun for DeRocher. He's ready. Motion in the slot. Rolling to his right. Wants to pass. Looking. Got some pressure. Flings it in the end zone.
He got it.
They convert. We've got a two-point ball game. Oh, baby, look out. 22-20 here at Catoctin High School. This one's a game for the classics.
Anyone who could count it out, Boonesboro, they're not paying attention. This game
Absolutely.
Is very close, and I had a hunch they'd pull off a comeback.
Well, Catoctin did it to them in the first game of the season. It's only fitting that they would pay him back. All right, let's get some scores for you here. Two-point conversion, good. I'm trying to figure out exactly. Oh, it's the Westminster game. All right. So the Owls lead the South Hagerstown Rebels 17-14 with 6 minutes left in the third. That's a big game. Yeah. South Hagerstown up on top by three. Okay, Boonesboro tees it up on their own 40 where they'll kick off to the Cougars, who have one deep standing on his own 24. Here we go. Here's the run-up. Squib kick straight ahead. Hit at the first level, dropped on and taken at the 34 where the Cougars play it safe and just fall on the ball. Smart special teams coverage. And that'll give Christian Michael and his offensive squad the ball, first and 10 from their own 34 with a slim two-point lead. Let's see if the Cougars can answer back or if the Boonesboro defense can get the ball back and give their team a chance to go ahead.
And Catoctin doesn't have to do anything crazy here. They just have to keep doing what they've been doing, and they could see a score on this drive.
Spread formation, Michael. Pitches it to the deep back around the right end. Got some guys. Breaks through them. Straight ahead. Good, strong running by Baker as he gets eight on the carry. Let's call it seven. All the way out to the 41-yard line. Second and three for the Cougars. That was a good run.
That was.
So they spread the defense. Then they pitched it out to the right. And he just ran through the gap. Second and four. Michael wants to pass. Three-step drop, throws it up, wide open, and it's caught! And he breaks one tackle. It's a foot race all the way down the sideline as streaking Travis Fields will score. And that's a 60-yard touchdown pass to Travis Fields from Christian Michael. And just that fast, lightning strikes at Catoctin High School.
Mr. Clutch, here he is again.
The defender had no chance. He was wide open as he curled out into the flat just outside the defender. And then when he made that plant and cut up field, the defender slipped and fell, and it was a foot race.
He made that plant when the one dry spot on the field.
You're right. So in this track meet, once again, the offense scores. Two-point conversion for the Cougars now. Straight ahead. Trying to punch it in. Catoctin signaling no. He did not get the conversion. So the score will stand at 28-20 here with 11:08 to go in the half. And my goodness gracious, this is just an offensive performance in the second half, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
One of these two teams will have a chance to go up to Fort Hill next week and play for the 1A West Championship. Cougars have an 8-point lead and 11 minutes separating them from the trip. Boonesboro still in this game, plenty of time.
Absolutely.
No give up in either one of these teams, and Boonesboro with a very impressive drive in the last two possessions to keep this game close.
Yeah, all Boonesboro needs is one lucky play, and we're looking at a tied game again.
So the PA people are playing the Rocky song, Eye of the Tiger, as the Cougars tee the ball up on their own 40 at the north end of the Catoctin High School football stadium.
Up, all the way with them, all the way. Keep going.
Here's the run-up and the kick. It's a squibber up the middle. Hits a player, bounces off, ricochets, and it's taken all the way down at the 40, where the Warriors will have it first and 10 once again. Call it the 39 on the spot as the Cougars and the Warriors play. It's kind of like pinball out there, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm not a fan of these short squib kicks. If you can kick it deep, if you have the ability to, you got to do that and pin them back at least around their 20.
They can't kick it deep. So it becomes a battle of is the ball going to squirt out? Boonesboro, double wing set, close formation, motions into the backfield. Where the quarterback rolls to his right. He wants to pass, looking deep. He flings it out deep into the coverage. Caught, intercepted. Not sure, because there's nothing but mud on those numbers, but one of the Cougars stepped right in front of the receiver and picked it at the 31, and the Cougars will get the ball back right away on the INT.
Well, looks like the Cougars got the lucky play that time.
He was open, too.
Yeah.
But that left corner read underneath and came off of his receiver and adjusted back to the cross slant, the deep slant, and he settled up underneath it and made the pick. Ball's on the 31, Catoctin has it, and all they have to do right here is basically student body right, student body left, and just drive it home.
Yeah, they, like I said earlier, they just need to keep doing what they've been doing. If it's not broke, don't fix it.
Well, they're going to a spread offensive set. Michael wants to pass, stops, goes for the draw, gets caught in the backfield, and dropped for a three-yard loss. So they get tricky, and Boonesboro blitzes right up the middle, and they sack him.
It's almost like they're...
you got to run the straight-ahead quick hitter. The quick hitter. Because Boonesboro's coming on the run blitz now.
Yeah, you can't get cute right here.
Second and 12 for the Cougars, all the way back to the 28 now, as Michael brings them out into the spread. Motion. Hands off, fakes it, pulls it down, wants to throw, got a man. Incomplete. Tipped away. It was a low ball, and he couldn't put it away. The receiver actually... it hit him on the wrist and bounced up in the air and down, incomplete. So the Cougars need 12. And they're in dangerous position right here. They need to protect the ball.
Yeah. We know they can go with deep plays, but they also have to make sure they don't turn it over here.
Michael wants to pass, three-step drop, got pressure, has to scramble out, throws it, caught, and he drops the ball. It's on the ground, but he gets it back. They're saying it's incomplete. He never put the ball away.
Punt return now.
They're saying that the receiver did not put the ball away for two steps. The ball came right out. It looked to me like he fumbled it.
Yeah, I was convinced that was a fumble. I thought Boonesboro recovered.
Yeah, I'd have to see the tape on that one.
Yeah.
Rerun the video. Let's see the rewind on that one. All right, so the clock is running. The Cougars will punt it away. We've got a flag on the field. It's going to be delay of game against the Cougars.
I got 11. Tell them to recount.
No, there's 11 dudes out here.
Count them.
That's twice in this damn game.
They're calling, I think they're calling too many players on the field. Not a delay. They wave it off. So he threw the flag for too many players on the field. They'd made the count, picked it up, and waved it off. So here we go. Catoctin punter's back deep on his own 15. Good snap, gets a good kick away, nice high spiraling kick, taking it to 40. Out to the 45, 50, still on his feet, into Cougars territory and driven down at the 46. So Boonesboro with excellent field position will come out of this one looking good.
They had excellent field position if he just fielded that and caught a fair catch, but I mean with that extra almost 10 yards.
Good return.
Yep.
All right. Cougars lead at 28-20 with 9:58 to go in the game. We got us one heck of a football game right here. Boonesboro taking their time, double wing set, wing in motions, sets in the backfield. DeRocher hands off to the straight ahead on the trap. In the second level, still on his feet. He's going to go all the way. One man can catch him and brings him down. Touchdown, Boonesboro. And just that quickly, on a 45-yard run, Boonesboro answers back, and we've got a two-point game.
That was amazing run blocking on that play. You could have driven a truck through that hole.
The fullback, no less. Holubinko.
I don't think anyone touched him 3 to 5 yards downfield on that play.
All the way down, 45-yard run by Holubinko to score. And now the biggest play of the game right here. Boonesboro wants to go for the two-point conversion to tie it up. Down by two with 9:49 to go in this game. Here come the Warriors. DeRocher wants to pass, rolling to his right, looking. He's going to pull it down and scramble. It's a foot race. He throws it in the end zone. It's caught. Totally converted. Tie ball game. 28 even up. Wow, what a play. At the last second, DeRocher, who looked like he was going to try to run it in, pulled up, stopped, and fired it into the end zone just a half a foot before the receiver went out of bounds.
That was a brilliant play. Brilliant play by both quarterback and wide receiver.
We got us a ball game, ladies and gentlemen. This is a cardiac moment for both of these teams. 9:49 to go on the clock, tied up at 28 apiece. It's anybody's game right now. Both seasons on the line. 10 minutes to go. Anything can happen.
And who would have saw this back on August, what, 31st?
The first game of the season, right.
Who would have saw it ending like
this? Yeah, can you imagine if someone said to you back on August the 31st that these two teams would be tied for the 1A semifinal with nine minutes to go in the game? Here we go. All right, Boonesboro tees it up on their own 40. One Cougar back deep, but so far we've had no deep kicks, nothing but squibs up the middle, and I don't expect that to change. Here comes the run-up. He kicks it a line drive, one hop, and taking it 20, 21, straight ahead, still on his feet, driving, and down. Now they're challenging that and saying that he was down on one knee. It looked like he was.
He definitely was. He was down when he got that.
They're going to mark it back where the knee was, yes. So the referees get that one right. Because he did slide down to one knee when he made the one-hop catch. So that's a big deal right there because that's a difference of 15 yards.
Yep.
First and 10 for the Cougars on their own 26-yard line as Michael brings them out of the huddle. Spread formation. Michael pitches to the back around the right end. Cuts it upfield. Plant still on his feet. Oh, my goodness. He's going to go all the way. He's gone all the way. Catoctin scores on a 75-yard run from the first play of scrimmage. Oh, my word. How could it get any more dramatic than that?
The running back got the angle. He got the edge. The one man that could have gotten him on pursuit just ran the wrong angle. And he was gone for six.
Well, I'm going to tell you, this is going to be a huge point conversion right here.
Absolutely.
Because I don't believe Catoctin's as good as this at this two-point conversion game as Boonesboro is. And they're going to try to punch it in right here. So here come the Cougars out. Michael from the shotgun. Wants to pass, looking right, throws the fade out in the corner, up in the air, broken up. no good. So the score will stand at 34-28, a 6-point lead for the Cougars, and that could come back to haunt them.
Catoctin ran that same play for a 2-point conversion, but converted it back in the first half. Surprised they ran that again.
9:27 to go in this game. It's a track meet. Want to see if we can get caught up on some other scores from around the league as we get ready for this umpteenth kickoff. I don't know how many kickoffs we've had here. Never expected this high scoring game.
Hey, one returner is going to sneak up. The other one's going to stay back.
Blake gets on the scoreboard against Linganore on a 3-yard run. The score 45-8 now. Linganore on top with a running clock over at Linganore High School. Bears up 31-14 over Liberty.
Sounds like Oakdale's in a close one.
Here we go. Cougars on the north end of the stadium will run up. Here's the kickoff. High end over end kick. Bounces once, taken at the 40, the 15, out to the 20. 25, caught, drives ahead, and falls down at the 27-yard line where the Warriors will take over first and 10. So they kicked it away.
Yeah, they actually kicked it kind of deep on that one.
Well, kind of deep, maybe kind of deep. Not. I've seen deeper kicks. Yeah. There's a kid for Oakdale that kicked.
Oh, Ritter.
Yeah, wait, we've got an alert coming in. We've got an emergency alert. We'll step aside. Okay, the alert's done. Here we go. Spread formation for Boonesboro, wing in motion. Pitch to the deep back, off right tackle. Got some running room into the secondary, 7 level. Brings it all the way out, 10-yard gain. Give him 11 on the forward progress to the 40. First and 10, Warriors.
Great blocking on that play by the Boonesboro offensive line, creating wide holes for that running back to get through.
Doesn't seem to be a whole lot of defense going on out there right now.
No, the Boonesboro offensive line is doing what they want with Catoctin.
Here we go. Pitch to the other side. Caught in the backfield. Falls back to the original line of scrimmage. No gain. Call it second and 10 for the Warriors. No huddle. Hurry up for Boonesboro. Double wing set for DeRocher. Wing in motion. Sets in the backfield. Hand off to the lone back on the trap. Bounces it outside. Breaks one tackle and another. Holobinko stiff arms a guy into the secondary. Jukes another one. Drags. He could go. Oh, my goodness. He was one tackle from going all the way again. That guy can run.
That guy's like a little Larry Zonka or something out there.
Exactly. All the way down to the 30-yard line. A 40-yard carry again by Holobinko, and they've got to start taking that guy's legs out.
Yeah, you cannot arm tackle that guy.
First and 10 from the Catoctin 30 now as the Warriors are threatening. DeRocher turns around and sets Holobinko on his right hip pocket. Turns and pitches it to him off right tackle. Good block, cuts it back upfield, sticks his nose down and drags all the tacklers with him for about 5. Call it 6 yards on the carry. That'll bring up 2nd and 4 for Boonesboro. And they're starting to get that beast in motion, aren't they?
Yeah. Once you get Holobinko moving, it's almost impossible to stop him. He last year against Catoctin, he ran
almost 150 yards in the opening week.
The white jerseys are no longer white. They're dark brown, and here comes DeRocher. Motion again across the formation into the backfield. Hand off to Holubinko. He slips and falls in the backfield. No gain. He lost a half a yard. So he planted on that cut, on that plant cut, and he comes off limping.
Hopefully it's nothing too serious.
Well, when he planted that, he set that plant foot, it slipped right out on that wet turf. Well, that wet mud. There's no turf left. And that'll bring up third and five now for Boonesboro. No huddle. Quickly out to the line of scrimmage. DeRocher's ready. From the shotgun, he sends motion across. Hands off on the jet, pulls it down and goes straight ahead for the first down. There's a late flag into the pile. It looks like that one's coming back. I believe that's holding. That back judge, when he throws that flag,
it's almost
nine times out of ten. Holding is the call, and that one's coming back. That's a bad call for Boonesboro. That was a good play, and that hurts.
Well, I mean, at this point in the game, with this score, it's automatic fourth down territory. I mean,
true.
You have to.
But they were looking at third and two.
Now they're
looking at third and, going to call it probably, excuse me, they'll put it back to second and 14. Maybe 15, second and 15. Depending on the spot of the infraction, they mark it off now. So the ball comes all the way out. So it's going to be second and 13.
Oh, no, wait. They changed it back to third.
It is third. Third and 13. Binky fell on second down. He's got a scramble. Caught in the backfield and sacked. Number 11 on the backfield sack for the Cougars. And there's a... Oh, I thought it was a flag. That was a football being thrown in. I thought that was a late flag, but that was a football flying across the field from the sideline. So, fourth and let's call it 18. Boonesboro's going for it. Biggest play of the game right here. Cougars in a four-deep zone. Rolling to his left. He wants a pass. He stops, sets, throws. No, pumps it, throws it into coverage. It's a jump ball, and it falls incomplete. All the way down at the five-yard line, it was any man's ball as everybody went up for it.
And there are no late flags, so no worrying about interference.
So Boonesboro turns it over on downs on a great defensive stop in what I said was probably the play of the game right there. Cougars have it 34-28, a six-point lead at 5:05 to go, and they come out in their power wishbone formation. Pitch to the left halfback. He stumbles, falls, drives ahead. Still moving, a big rugby scrum. Haven't blown the whistle, there it is. Give him 4 yards on the carry.
Just wouldn't stop moving those feet. He refused to go down on that play.
And he slipped on the first cut. Second and six now for the Cougars. Here they come. 5 minutes separating one of these two teams from a trip up to Northern Maryland. Northwestern Maryland. Wishbone formation, Cougars. Michael under center, tosses it to the right halfback, straight ahead, caught from behind and dragged down at the line of scrimmage, no gain. That'll bring up third and six. With 4:09 to go, the Cougars need to move the chains to keep that Boonesboro, that potent Boonesboro offense off the field.
Yeah,
because Boonesboro is going to get it back with plenty of time.
And they will. I think they'll score again if they get the ball back.
Absolutely.
No doubt about that. They have the momentum here.
Here come the Cougars. Spread formation. They're showing pass. Look for Michael to keep it up the middle. He drops, wants to pass, got pressure, has to scramble to his right, flings it out to the right, caught, first down yardage, still on his feet, drags all the way down to the 35-yard line. That was the play of the game. What a clutch catch in the middle by Hunter Grimes, number 81 for the Cougars. Hooked up deep in the zone in the soft part, sat there and waited for Michael to clear on the scramble, and Michael fired it on the run 30 yards downfield to keep this drive alive for Catoctin. Down to 3 minutes to go in this game. The Cougars lead it by six. Wishbone formation. Michael under center, eight in the box. Toss to the left back around right end. He gets around the edge, still on his feet. He needed to stay in bounds on that one.
Yeah, definitely.
He ran out of bounds. Coaches need to talk to him about that.
Definitely have to stay in bounds at a time like this.
Good solid yardage, but when he got to that sideline, he should have cut it upfield and slid.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to be second and six now for the Cougars with the ball right on the 29-yard line in Warriors territory. Wishbone again. Now they bring a player out of the game. Let's see what the call was. Oh, they got an equipment problem with one of the linemen. So they have an official timeout to get the, it's the left tackle. No, left end. So they're ready. Michael tosses to the right back, trying to get around the edge, caught in the backfield, dropped for a 5-yard loss. Good defensive stop by the Warriors.
Yeah, they did not get fooled on they did not get fooled on that one.
It's going to bring up third and 10 for the Cougars as we go timeout. The Warriors call timeout to stop the clock and to try to figure out what to do with this third down situation they have. Let's see what they're going to dial up here as both teams have huddled up on their respective sides of the field. Boonesboro here on the near side, Catoctin to the far. Catoctin leading 34-28, 2:47 to go in the game. The Cougars, if they cannot convert, will want to try to pin the Warriors deep and lean on the defense to close this one out. Boonesboro, on the other hand, with that high-powered, potent offense, wants to get as much time as they can by stopping the clock on this timeout. Here we go. Spread formation. Michael showing pass. Long snap count. Michael taking his time. Read option, pitches to the outside, cuts it upfield, still on his feet, drives to the marker, 9-yard gain on the carry. They spot him all the way down to the 26. It'll be fourth and short.
Catoctin got lucky on that one, honestly. There should have been a false start on that.
He moved early?
Yeah. One of the, I think the right tackle.
Right tackle did?
Yeah.
Call it fourth and three now for the Cougars. We've got another timeout on the field. As both teams huddle up, we're going to stick with you here. Try to figure this one out. 2:31 to go. Catoctin up by six. They have the ball. It's fourth down, 3 yards to go. Let's see what wizardry Coach Williams dials up for his offense. They play the Hawaii 5-0 theme out there on the stadium speakers. Here's a final. Linganore defeats Blake 45-8. Linganore will play at home next Friday night against what was last check was Westminster over South Hagerstown. Let's see if we've got an update on that score. The Bears lead at 38-14 now. with 38 unanswered points. Now there's a flag on the field. Let's see what the call is. A lot of pointing going on.
The offensive lineman moved last two times.
Let's see. The referees huddle up.
Back them up.
And we have the call.
Back them up.
Illegal motion on the Cougars. False start. So that'll back them up five and change the whole scenario for the Cougars.
And if I'm Catoctin, this is automatically a passing down.
You're going to throw it down there?
Yeah. I mean,
I'd try to coffin kick it.
Here
we go. Spread formation for Michael. Fourth and eight. He wants to pass. Straight drop. Got to scramble to his right. He flings it deep. It's a jump ball. Incomplete. So the Cougars will turn it over on downs, and Boonesboro has 2 minutes and 32 seconds standing between them and a trip to Fort Hill. This is just the way you write the script, Will. It's Boonesboro's game to win now.
Yeah, if I'm Catoctin, I'm not sure what. I mean,
here we go. Quickly after the line of scrimmage. Shotgun formation for DeRocher. Wants to pass. Rolling to his right. Got the ball. Pulls it down. Runs with it. Still on his feet. Breaks one tackle and dropped after a 4 yard gain.
Run the ball in.
So the keeper looks like it was good for five on the forward progress.
This Boonesboro offense does not have a sense of urgency.
Yeah, that doesn't seem to be a sense of urgency, and we're all the way down. The clock is running. We're down to 2 minutes now. We still have a ball boy on the field. Now they're off. Rolling to his right. He wants to pass. Looking deep. He flings it up there. Wide open. Caught. All the way down into Cougars territory at the 42-yard line. Boonesboro has it first and 10 at the 42 with a minute 48 on the clock.
They have to get up. Oh, there we go. I was about to say, the Boonesboro, they're starting to show some sense of urgency, finally, with this two-minute drill.
DeRocher, pointing, directing, ready. Motion across the formation, low snap, takes it, stumbles a bit, rolls to his right, wants to pass. Got a man on a quick out, immediately caught and tackled after a 4 yard gain. Good solid tackling by that Cougars linebacker. That'll bring up second and six. Gets a good mark, they're going to make it second and five. Hurry up offense, down to a minute 13 to go. Boonesboro, second and five from the 39. There's a motion penalty as the slot receiver moved towards the line of scrimmage first, and now they're signaling off sides. It's encroachment on the defense. It looked like a motion on the slot, and that is a huge mistake by the Catoctin defense. That moves the ball all the way down to the 24-yard line, and that could end up to be really a serious mistake by that Catoctin defense. DeRocher, fresh set of downs. Fakes the reverse. Going deep. Got a man wide open, and he drops it. That ball is muddy. His hands are muddy. He holds his face mask in disbelief that he couldn't put that one away. But it's understandable. There's too much mud on everything out there.
Yeah, everything is too slippery at this point in the game.
Second and 10. 44 seconds to go as the clock stops. I think they should go back to that Holubinko run again. What do you think, Will?
Oh, definitely. He was their bread and butter. He was getting it done.
Here they come. Holubinko right behind DeRocher. Motion on the slot. They hand off, fake the reverse, rolls to his left, wants to throw, got some pressure, runs it up, still on his feet, tackled and brought down after a 5-yard gain. It's going to bring up third and short with the clock down to 30 seconds. Boonesboro can get maybe two more plays off if they hurry. Obviously, we're in two down territory in this one. They're quickly to get set. The ball boy didn't even get off the field before the ball was hutting. They spike it to stop the clock. So we're at fourth and five with 17 seconds to go in the game. I did not like that call at all. I think you got to take the shot on that one.
Yeah.
One more play for the whole season for both these teams. Mano a mano, defense against offense. Winner take all. 34-28, Catoctin leads it, 17 seconds, and a fourth down. Rolling to his right, wants to pass, got some pressure from behind. Going to run with it, has to pull it down, he flings it. It's a jump ball up in the air. Caught! It's caught! No, he dropped it. It's incomplete. Oh, my goodness gracious. It fell out of his hands. Another slippery ball moment. And that was the season. What a football game we had here. 7 seconds on the clock. Cougars take it over. And they'll go into the victory formation celebration, knee down to take it to Fort Hill. Wow, it doesn't get any better than this. What a game. I thought for sure, Will, he caught that.
Yeah, but squeaked right out as he was going down.
Two drops in that series, muddy balls. Because you don't have time when you're running hurry up and the clock's running out on you. You don't have the time to be able to stop and get a fresh ball out there.
Nope.
And that's it. The Catoctin Cougars are going to the regional championship, defeating the Boonesboro Warriors 34-28 as time expires here. Let's get that Cougar snarl going here in the stadium and over the radio. The Cougars win it. Congratulations. All right, Cougars fans victorious, up on their feet. Two teams meet at the center of the field to shake hands and congratulate each other. Everybody walks out of this stadium with their head held high, right, Will?
Oh, absolutely. They put up a winning effort. No one should be discouraged after that game.
Best game of the year. You got your money's worth in this one. What a football game.
And if I'm correct, this is Catoctin's first home win since we beat Dunbar 13-12 in the 09
in the first
season.
Round of the playoffs, yeah?
No, that was the semifinals.
That was the game where Ray Lewis walked out on the field.
Yeah. Yep.
With Ray Rice.
Yep.
Ray Lewis and Ray Rice drove up in an Escalade, parked right in the daggone end zone and walked out on the field.
And we sent them home with a loss.
I remember that one well. All right, we will step aside for our last break, and then we'll be back for our post-game wrap-up and our player of the game. We'll be right back.
Serving our community for over 50 years with quality service at a fair price, Brownies Auto Repair employs only ASE certified technicians. Brownies is one of only 33 shops in the state of Maryland designated as an ASE Blue Seal of Excellence repair facility. They want to help you maintain your vehicle in a manner that keeps it trouble-free and fun to drive. Stop by today. That's Brownies Auto Repair, located on Frederick Street in Walkersville, a proud sponsor of Walkersville High School Athletics.
The Catoctin Wildlife Preserve has over 600 exotic animals spread over 50 acres in the foothills of the Catoctin Mountains just off Route 15 south of Thurmont. Enjoy our personal style of education and exhibits with interactive touch and feel opportunities. Open throughout November, weekends only from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Check out our website, CatoctinWildlifePreserve.org, or call us at 301-271-3180. That's 301-271-3180. Catoctin Wildlife Preserve. Amazing new animal friends are waiting to meet you today. Where do you get your real-time information? News, weather, traffic, school delays, and cancellations. At Cool 1450 AM, one of our most important resources is FrederickScanner.com. Live traffic cams, weather cams, city and county resources, police, fire and rescue. Anyone living, working, or traveling in and around Frederick should bookmark FrederickScanner.com on their PC or go to their Facebook page and download the mobile app today. FrederickScanner.com, a live information window to Frederick County. For over 30 years, the McLeaf family has been bringing the tradition of home country cooking and fun to our region at the Mountain Gate Family Restaurant. Dine in at the restaurant or catering on the go. And for special events, holidays, and weddings, check out their Green Grove Gardens in Greencastle, Pennsylvania. Located just off Route 15 in Thurmont, Mountain Gate Family Restaurant features a huge buffet with something for the whole family. Breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Mountain Gate Family Restaurant is famous for their delicious homemade cooking, their fresh desserts, and their unique gift shop. Mountain Gate Family Restaurant is not just a place to eat, but an experience. Their renowned Thursday evening gospel sings feature some of the greatest groups around. And don't forget, with Thanksgiving right around the corner, now's the time to make a reservation to enjoy the finest homestyle holiday dinner anywhere. Call 301-271-4373. That's 301-271-4373 to make your reservation today. That's Mountain Gate Family Restaurant, a Thurmont dining tradition. Stop by today.
Well, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations. Catoctin Cougars victorious over the Boonesboro Warrior on one of the best games we've seen in years. The final score, 34-28. Who's your key to the game? What was your key to this game?
Honestly, Fields, the wide receiver, Travis Fields. He came up with one big touchdown and one crucial catch. I think without him, the game doesn't go Catoctin's way.
Well, field conditions were terrible. It was a a struggle with the conditions and planting your feet and moving, and the ball was slick and all day long. But I mean, how many points did we put on? That was 60 some points on the board in these conditions. Imagine what would happen if we'd had dry field out there.
Oh, absolutely.
We'd have gotten over the century mark. So, all right. So we've gotten word that Fort Hill has defeated Southern Garrett. And so Catoctin will be going to Fort Hill next week, next Friday. They will travel up I-70 all the way up into the northwestern part of the state to the great stadium at Fort Hill, collegiate-style stadium.
This is a matchup Cougars fans have been looking for almost a decade since we went to states. We always faced Dunbar, but we never faced Fort Hill in the playoffs.
So if the scores stand from around the league, it looks like Westminster-South Hagerstown is still too early and too close to call. But Westminster with a slight lead, 17-14 over at South Hagerstown. But Oakdale has defeated Liberty, and they will face Damascus at Damascus next Friday. That is going to be a huge game.
It's like, which game do you choose, Oakdale at Damascus or Catoctin at Fort Hill?
Well, that's the great thing. That's the great thing about Frederick County football is that you've got three teams that are going to be in the second round of the playoffs. You've got Linganore in the 3A, you've got Oakdale in the 2A, and Catoctin in the 1A. So, I mean, this is great for Frederick County football.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
All right, so just so our viewers know and our listeners, we will be covering the Fort Hill game. We will apply to the MPSSAA to go all the way to Fort Hill next Friday and bring you that game live for the Catoctin Cougars travel up to meet the Fort Hill Sentinels, and that's going to be a very interesting situation.
All of Western Maryland's going to show up for that one.
Yes, it will. All right. Well, Will, it's great to have you back in the booth. Our player of the game, congratulations, Travis Fields. Hollis Zimmerman doing our video feed. Thank you so much for being here. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great Veterans Day weekend. Don't forget, Sunday morning, 11 a.m., we'll be broadcasting the service live from Trinity UCC Church in Thurmont, the Veterans Day celebration, one of the best celebrations of our veterans past and present around in Northern Frederick County and the region. We invite you to come join us. Stay for lunch afterwards. Have a great time. Thank you to everyone, the entire Cool 1450 AM team, for making this game possible. Congratulations to the Cougars, the fans. Our thanks to the administration of Catoctin High School and Athletic Director Keith Brook for giving us the opportunity to broadcast this game to you. We'll see you. Have a great weekend. We'll see you next Friday night.